Good morning to my dear friends of MSCBS part 1. Today our topic is relationship between the organism. Means you can say that there exists a relationship between one organism to the another organism for the survival on the earth. And majority of the animals are regarded as free living. बहुत सारे ऐसे एनिमल्स हैं जिसे कि हम नॉर्मली बोलते हैं कि दे आर फ्री लिविंग, बट इन ए स्ट्रिक्ट सेंस नो ऑर्गेनिज्म इन द नेचुरल कंडीशन इज इंडिपेंडेंट फ्रॉम द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. मतलब इस वर्ल्ड में कोई भी एक ऐसा ऑर्गेनिज्म नहीं है जो कि इंडिपेंडेंट है. इन वन वे और द अनदर वे दे डिपेंड्स ऑन अदर फॉर देयर फूड और रेस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स. सो यू कैन नॉट से दैट वन ऑर्गेनिज्म इज ए फ्री लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो इन अ नेचुरल कंडीशन यू कैन से दैट ईच एंड एवरी लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म, इवन इफ दे आर फ्री, but they depend on the other organism for the some purpose, maybe the food, shelter or nutrient, etc. So however, some animals have developed some special relationship with the members of own or the with the membership members of their own or other species. So today's topic, that is relationship between the organism, it is from the same one, paper one, you know, the first paper, that is ecology and ecosystem. And today we are going to take this topic or discuss about the topic. So interspecific relationship, or you can find out a term called the interspecific relationship. And normally you can say that the relationship between the organism may be divided into two. It may be the interspecific, and the another is said to be the intraspecific. So just we have to study about the interspecific. But what do you mean by interspecific relationship? The member of the two or more species may establish relationship through their cooperation. Matlab, ek member with the member of the two or more species may establish relationship through their cooperation. Or may this cooperation may be the beneficial coaction. Matlab, agar कोई भी दो मेंबर, कंसिडर टू मेंबर्स ऑफ और टू और मोर स्पीशीज हो सकते हैं, इट मे बी वन अदर स्पीशीज और मे बी द सेम स्पीशीज. सो टू इन दिस टाइप ऑफ रिलेशनशिप द मेंबर ऑफ टू और मोर स्पीशीज मे एस्टैब्लिश रिलेशन, इन दोनों के बीच में एक रिलेशनशिप स्टैब्लिश होता है. And this relationship is, this cooperation may be the beneficial. कभी कभी ये जो relationship होता है may be the beneficial, मतलब उनके फायदे के लिए होता है. And sometimes this coaction is harmful coaction. Or you can say that somewhere one organism is harmed at the base of the other. Or you can say that here in this case, in this type of relationship, the members of two or more species may establish the relationship through their cooperation or through their discooperation. कभी वो cooperate करते हैं, beneficial coaction उसमें express करता है. And when both are benefited, then it is said to be the beneficial. Beneficial cooperation के लिए वो क्या करते हैं कि एक दूसरे organism से या species के साथ एक relation maintain करते हैं. और sometimes maybe due to the discooperation, दोनों के बीच में कोई cooperation नहीं होता है. So you can say that here one species is harmed. So it can be classified as follows. It may be, again, this interspecific relationship This interspecific relationship may be divided into the four types or classified into the four types. First one is said to be the antagonism. Second one is said to be the commensalism. Third one is said to be the symbiosis, and the fourth one is said to be the epizootism. So these are the four type of classification of the interspecific relationship. Ek organism dusre organism ke saath kis prakar ka relationship maintain karta hai, establish karta hai, can be normally divided into the four types. So today we are going to discuss all these points one by one. The first topic, that is said to be the antagonism. So what do you mean by antagonism? Here in this case, that is antagonism, it is a harmful coaction. You can say that it is one of the harmful coaction between members of two different species, in which one species is benefited at the cost of the other. So one species is benefited at the cost of other, matlab dusre ko harm karke wo benefit hota hai. So antagonism may be distinguished, if this antagonism may be again distinguished into three types. The first one is said to be the antibiosis. The second one is said to be the parasitism. And the third one is said to be the predation. So antagonism, you can say that it is a harmful, एक प्रकार का harmful coaction होता है, जिसमें कि एक benefited होता है at the cost of others. दूसरे को harm करके एक को benefit होता है, दूसरा harmed होता है. So this type of coaction again divided in three types, that is said to be the antibiosis. Always remember that this type of antagonism में जो होता है, it is a harmful coaction होता है, जिसमें कि एक benefit होता है at the base at the cost of the other. तो दूसरे को हार्म करके ही एक को बेनिफिट मिलता है. सो एंटीबायोसिस, अगेन वन इज बेनिफिटेड, अनदर इज हार्म. पैरासिटिज्म, हियर आल्सो पैरासाइट्स, वन इज हार्म्ड एंड वन इज बेनिफिटेड. अगेन प्रीडेशन आल्सो, वन इज हार्म्ड एंड अनदर इज बेनिफिटेड. सो वी कैन से दैट इट इज वन ऑफ द एंटागोनिज्म इज वन ऑफ वन टाइप ऑफ द हार्मफुल कोएक्शन. As you know that the antagonism may be distinguished into antibiosis, parasitism and predation. And so we are going to discuss about the antibiosis. So antibiosis is the first one under the antagonism. And this antibiosis, the name itself suggests that